Hi, I'm Jackie and this is Nail Polish and Power Tools. In this video, I'm going to show you how to take a digital logo and turn it into a really cool sign using these boards. For this project, we are going to be using a chop saw, a driver, a bandsaw, a sander, a brad nailer, a circular saw, and really important, these aren't power tools, but we are going to need a computer with the logo as well as a projector. So here is the logo that we'll be using. We're just going to modify it a little bit for ease and simplicity. So here, we're going to go ahead and we're going to get rid of these little letters here. All City Church, we're going to just have it say All City. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And then I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this outer white line. So now, that's what it looks like. But if you'll notice, because the church is gone, the All City and the red box are no longer centered. So we're gonna go ahead and center like so. So it's gonna be easier for tracing if we turn this into outline. So I'm gonna go ahead and change the appearance. Gonna make the solids invisible and give it a nice black line with a stroke of 2. Wow, these are absolute, I need to get new. Can you see how horrible that is? Safety first. The first step of our project is to cut our boards and assemble them into a small pallet wall. So here we have our little pallet wall all laid out. I've been intentional in alternating full boards and partial boards and the seams from left to right. We're going to fix these temporarily to these 2x4s so that way it'll all move together as a unit, which will come in handy when it's time to trace the logo. Beautiful. Here we go. This is our pallet wall. Now we are going to use our projector to trace the logo onto the wood. Dang it, but now this you don't want. Holy moly.
Holy guacamole.
This is just gonna be hard. So I have to be super careful not to put weight on this because,
I'm gonna do this fast.
We're gonna go ahead and take this outside and we're gonna go over the lines because they're pretty faint right now. I kind of sketched. Now for our secret weapon, colored pencils.
We're gonna color the inside of the letters blue and the outside red. This will help us keep organized once we've cut the boards up into tiny pieces. Now it's time to disassemble our pallet wall so we can cut out our design using a bandsaw.
So, we're only going to be cutting out of these three center boards. Well, I guess four boards if you count that. So these we're just going to set aside. Oh man, this might be kind of tricky. We'll start with this piece. I've actually never used this before. I've used a bandsaw, just not this particular guy. So hopefully it works. So this piece, we need to make sure we don't lose it, because this is going to be, if we lose this, like the whole thing's messed up. I should get a bucket. Shall we try piecing it together?
Once our puzzle is complete, we can use wood glue to make it permanent.
Gonna be a fun puzzle. All the reverse pieces, because the cool thing about this is even though we have all of our pieces here for our sign, I made sure to save all of the negative pieces so we can actually create a whole nother sign just reverse. So instead of the letters being sunk in, they're gonna be popping up.
Inverse.
Sure.
After the glue is dried, the next step is to sand our pieces. And now it's time to paint. It is getting pretty late. We're gonna hit pause for now and check it out in the morning and see how it looks.
All right. These boards look really good. It's time to cut out the backing for our sign. We're gonna paint this piece white because that's the color of the letters in the logo. Now that our sign is assembled, we're gonna glue it down, and then we're gonna come through with a brad nailer to fix it in place. Now we're going to rip the outside perimeter with a circular saw and clean it up with a sander. Our final step is painting the edges of our sign.
If you've enjoyed this video, feel free to like and subscribe, or you can follow me on Instagram at nailpolishandpowertools.